window, but I'm on this every day. You cannot run with me, but I'm a heavyweight. Baby, I know what's coming, I could barely wait. And when it was on, they wanted me gone, boy, I'm here to stay. Stop calling me little bro, I got mileage on me. Walked in with the whole team and we riding on it. More action and no talk, I went quiet on it. Walked in with the whole team and we riding on it.
Hey, I don't be with him, he's so basic. Boy, you the op and your bros hating. All of them fake, I see both faces. Scared of the whip, it's a ghost racing. I knock them down to their cold cases. Marathon run, I'ma slow pace it. They did not want me to go places. Foil clearance like the gold place. And if we believe I'm...
Time was tight. We had an autograph signing in just a few hours, but I wanted to make sure I got enough work in with the new guys. Practice seemed to fly by. We all left the field feeling pretty pumped for our next game together.
Today, from CenturyLink Field in Seattle, Washington, it's week 5 of the NFL on EA Sports.
There are few cities finer on a clear afternoon than this one, and we have a picture-perfect clear afternoon. Heck, you can see all the way to Mount Rainier in the distance here at CenturyLink Field in Seattle. Today, it's an NFC West battle between the Los Angeles Rams and the Seattle Seahawks. So out come the Rams now for their first possession. Leading the charge will be their quarterback, always fun to watch, Deshaun Watson. First down, Watson. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And that's caught inside the 30. And all the way down to the 22-yard line. And that looked almost to be a case of, you know, a quarterback saying, hey, I'm going to throw this as far as I can and hope you run under it. Mission accomplished.
And that's how you start a drive, because you know they had this play in their back pocket, waiting for the right time to unleash it. And boy, did they pick the right opportunity. Unleashed it big time, and that was also a big time throw.
And that throw, pretty impressive, and even 61 yards through the air. So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. And he stopped immediately there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense, and know what they say. Those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side, and he'll get it down this time to the 17. 5 yards, now it's third and 5.
5 yards on the play. And it's
on third down, Akers. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. 7 yards on the pickup there. Now he's got first and goal. From the 10, first and goal. On the ground, it's Akers. And he'll take this from the 9 down to about the 7. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after him. Put the pressure on him.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Out of the gun, Watson. The quick slant caught. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the one-yard line. They wind up with six on the hook up there, but it's not enough. Fourth and goal. They'll run for it with Akers. And he didn't get there. Knocked backwards to the two-yard line. They stop him up short on fourth and goal from the one. And on the opening drive of the ball game, the defense comes up with a goal line stand. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And a really good show of force there as he gets through for four tough yards.
And while they hope to continue this drive, it's really already mission accomplished. They've given enough space now that if they have to punt the ball, they've done so with that first run.
On second down, Richard. And oh, his first carry, he loses the football. And they are going to score on the fumble return. Touchdown, LA. Even the great ones, some of the best, they're not immune to the fumble, and here it really hurts them.
If the ball gets away from any runner's body, that's when the defense pokes at it, swipes at it, swats at it, and finds a way to create a big play for themselves.
It's up, it's good, and the Rams take a 7-0 lead. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for six. This one taken just inside the 10. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line.
Oh, heck yeah. 27-yard line.
Seattle's offense coming back onto the field, ready for their second drive. And that last possession, really a gut punch. You seemingly had it working. You were in the midst of a very strong drive, then suddenly the fumble, and you're watching the back of a defender's jersey as he brings it all the way in the other direction.
There's not much more I can add to that. I thought you summarized it perfectly, partner. You just got to regroup.
Now Carson fumbles the football. And now the Rams have got it, going the other way. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line.
The ball carrier.
Not the trend he wanted to start the season with, a fumble lost in both weeks 1 and 2. Now, it's not a disaster, but certainly not what he was looking for.
Got to get that fixed, because otherwise he shows up on every scouting report. I remember sitting in defensive rooms and hearing the scouting report from my coaches, and if someone had a particular problem carrying the ball and holding on to it, that was noted. Hey, make sure you give a little extra attention to him. Get after the football. He's dropped it the last couple of games.
And he'll take this one down near the 15. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
Let's just make this one succinct. Nice job there. All 11 guys on defense, diagnosing the jet sweep and putting it down.
From the gun on third, Watson. Just what Seattle was hoping for. The coverage holds, and now fourth down. It was Trey Flowers. Time, who got a hand in and broke it up. Now remember, they were unsuccessful earlier in this first quarter. Going for it on fourth, they're going to try a second time. Dancing to his left. He can run for it, and he will. And he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds. 8 yards that time, able to take off, and the result is a first down.
Brandon, if you're not rooting for the defensive team, that was a fun play to watch. Fourth down, all the throwing lanes are covered, and this guy says, let me do it myself. It shows off scrambling ability that you just can't teach.
And a missed tackle there as he pushes forward for a gain of 4. Second and goal from inside the 5. Again, it'll be Akers. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2. Now, they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. And not going to be able to push this forward. He runs into a wall right at the line of scrimmage. They'll look to run with Akers. And he takes it across for a Rams touchdown. Cam Akers. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Rams add on to their lead. Early on, they have all facets of the game working in tandem.
Yeah, you give the defensive touchdown early to give you the first score, and then your offense piggybacks on top of that and gets their own. And any coach we've ever talked to, we've had that conversation with them prior to the game, they always say, you know, if we can score on defense or special teams, that gives like a 95% chance of winning the game. I don't know if that number's correct, but it certainly does tend to play out that way, doesn't it?
It does. This one fielded at the 5. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That could be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. On second and 11 now. Wilson, he's set and got his man complete.
Pass him in.
And all the way down to the 40-yard line. It's a big play there for Seattle. And even 40 yards. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Oh, they'll try the sweep. It's Lockett with it. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 12 yards there and a first down.
I think the reason this play is so successful is not just the blocking at the point of attack, but how about the speed at which he takes the handoff? He's in motion already, so he's not coming from a flat start like a running back often is. He's at a full run by the time he gets the football.
On first down, it's Carson, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
This defense is really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
This will be caught just inside the 10. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. His first catch, good for 16 and a first.
Well, remember, they tried to give him the ball and let him run on the last play, but I think the light bulb went off in their play caller's mind, and this time, they get it to him the more conventional way, and it's much more successful as well.
And the Seahawks are going to be set up with a first and goal. He couldn't quite reach the chalk, but they'll have it at the 1 yard line. Second and goal from the 1. From the shotgun, Wilson. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown. Will Disley, his second touchdown on the season. And the Seahawks able to make this a close game again.
You got to figure down by the goal line. This is where a tight end earns his money, in the high traffic area. And he's able to work free in the middle of the end zone and grabs that one for a touchdown.
Michael, this game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. And this carries into the end zone. And not a good return here at all as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive, almost what we call the green light, red light theory.
He's got a man complete.
You thought you had it, didn't you?
10.
You thought you had it.
Touchdown, L.A. A big play there. 88 yards. And the Rams strike quickly here for 6 points. For as big and strong as some of these guys are, especially when you see them in full pads, it is sometimes hard to appreciate how truly fast they can move. That was incredible. A shotgun snap for Watson. And no, it falls incomplete. So the two-point conversion, no good. So unable to throw it in for two from the two. Let me ask you, as a former DB, what changes there around the goal line on a two-point conversion as far as how you're defending it?
You just make sure you never back up and you never retreat. You establish yourself really on the line of scrimmage. Put your heels on the...
Now a hit and a loose football. And now the Rams have got it. Going the other way.
Fumble on the play. Recovered by the Rams.
Watson on first down, looking for the end zone. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Throwing again is Watson, buying time to his left. His throw caught right around the 6. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it first and goal. A chance to really cap off a big first half here as they come up on first and goal. And it's caught. That catch good for only a couple.
My next teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come.
And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, L.A. From 3 yards out, and the Rams add on to their lead.
The Rams will line up.
There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
And this one incomplete. So they went for the two. They don't get it.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of two-point tries and see what the data tells us, because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be...
And he loses the football a second time.
Fumble on the play. Recovered by the Rams.
First and 10, Watson, flushed out right, and that is incomplete. Great coverage there all around, really didn't have many options to throw the football.
Very little chance that one was going to be completed. Every receiver was locked up.
At the 24-yard line.
On second and 10, Watson. That's complete to his tight end, Higbee. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. A good field position to start the drive, but under the gun now. And he's going to be taken down here. A sack back at the 32. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. And how about this? 4th and long, and they're going to go for it. He's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. Cooper Kupp, his 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Rams tack on to their advantage.
If you didn't know it, it won't surprise you to find out that this team leads the league in scoring. They've been a quick strike team all season long. There's another example. They did it again. This offensive coordinator, right now you can write his ticket towards being a head coach. He's advanced in the ways of offense.
So the call is made by Sean McVay. They're going to go for 2. From the gun, here's Watson. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Quandre Diggs. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, as most teams do in their two-point attempt, they pass the ball. Instead, it gets intercepted. And remember, if you pick it off, you got a chance to take it all the way back, get 2 points yourself, right?
Yeah, not the case there, but that's why you got to be really careful with those throws, especially to the outside.
holding receiving team.
Well, that holding call set him up with not great field position.
Not at all when you tack on the penalty. But that field position after the return wasn't terrific. It's not a great starting field position as well.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. He's going to loft one deep left side. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. A big play there. 85 yards. And the Seahawks are able to close the gap just a bit.
Well, you normally talk about the mobility and the accuracy first, but the arm strength, that's what can turn Russ into dangerous.
And I'm telling you, nothing will light up a crowd more than a play like that. Here in the stadium, all eyes were on the receiver streaking downfield, and you know everyone was thinking, throw it, he's open. What a connection there for the touchdown.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Going up top for Kupp. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Let's see who this is on. So flag for the contact, pass interference.
And I know that you're going to look at me and roll your eyes, and rightfully so, because you know what I'm going to say. Doesn't the defender have a right to the football as well?
No, I don't like defenders.
That's because you spent too much time with me. Okay, I'll side with you on this one. It's the correct call.
Here's second and 10 now from the 35. To throw again, Watson. And he comes back with one complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room. Going for it all. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And I think the ball's out. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll send you eastward to Orlando, standing by with that EA Sports Halftime Report now is Jonathan Coachman. Take it away, Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thank you very much. More from you, too, in just a bit.
And just like that, on we head to half number two. The Seahawks trailing, but they will have possession first here as we resume action in the third quarter. Here comes Richard on the return. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
At their own 26-yard line.
The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, let's see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time.
That's
I mean, that's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
That catch good for only a couple. Got it here at the 29 on second and 8. 26 Mike. From the gun, it's Wilson. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. John Johnson with the INT. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line. Tough one there. First drive of the third quarter, throw an interception, and now a chance that they could be an even a bigger hole if they can convert this into points.
Yeah, but how good do you feel if you're that defensive quarterback?
And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown Rams. Deshaun Watson, 4 touchdown passes now in the ball game. And the Rams use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6.
You have fun with this one, partner.
I am. He's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone, this guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving him up.
4 touchdown passes, carving him up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone. Taken in at the 3. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
At their own 22-yard line.
Seattle again getting ready to take over offensively.
They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up. Yeah. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there at that time, actually.
You think you might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working. And he'll get this out past the 45 and the 47. A nice chunk there on a first down run, and it's second and four.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
And he loses the football a second time. And now the Rams have got it going the other way. And the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line. Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to interfere?
This is caught inside the 15. And he is down deep into Seattle territory. A big play there for L.A. 47 yards. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. The nice footwork gets him just inside the 10 to the 9, but no further. They had the huge play last time. Here it is a much smaller gain of 2.
They'll go again here with Akers.
Oh, a heck of a move. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown.
Cam Akers,
his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Rams take advantage of the turnover to put up 6. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those 2 TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have 2 touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
This one fielded at the 5. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
You always hear about empty possessions. Some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, pump the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
Now this one to his running back out of the backfield. Now Carson fumbles the football, and the Rams have got it back.
Fumble on the play. Recovering.
Always costly to cough up that football. These defenders, they become so adept, though, at jarring it free.
Yeah, it's amazing that there aren't more fumbles caused, because now, if you're an offensive player, you go through ball security drills every single day. It's really not out of line to think you should take the ball to bed with you and just hold on to it. But the bottom line is, no matter how much you try to protect it, these guys are pretty good at finding ways to knock it out.
He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it 1st and goal.
1st and goal, Los Angeles.
Oh, how about this on 1st and goal?
And the Rams are going to have a 1st and goal forthcoming as he takes this down to about the 5-yard line.
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's 2nd and goal.
From the shotgun, here's a give to Akers.
Stops short, down at the 1. Had the great move, but couldn't get all the way to the end zone. Give him right around 4 on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown.
Cam Akers
with touchdown number 3 in the game and 6 on the year. And the Rams use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. He keeps carrying the ball into the end zone, and in this one, he's sort of carrying the team on his back.
He's the reason that they lead right now, no question about it. And you talk about on his back, he's not minding the extra weight at all, is he? Carrying that just as lightly
as he does the football. Yeah, what a great performance so far.
Those three touchdowns, it's got him in the lead.
And he returns this to the 22.
At their own 22-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Good word. I like it, though, because you're exactly right.
You like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
Get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
First and 10.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. He'll lock it with a grab over the middle. And he lost the football. And now the Rams have got it going the other way. And they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line. So that one will be accepted. So now a fresh set of downs, first and 10 after roughing the passer. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he's going to get this inside the 30. That one good for 14 and a Seahawk first.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
On first and 10, it's Wilson. That's complete to Disley, the tight end. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. After the incompletion, here now, 3rd and 2. To throw again is Wilson. And now a fumble. The ball's out. And now the Rams have got it going the other way.
Get off the
field. Three going down the left side. It's a foot race. And they are going to score on the fumble return. Touchdown, L.A. Oh, backbreaker. That'll drive the coach. The offensive coordinator just crazy. You get it all the way down there in the red zone. Can't capitalize. Instead, they go the other way on the fumble return for a touchdown.
How about the aggressiveness of the defense, though? They're not about to just fall on a fumble, are they? Scoop and score is their motto, and they just did it.
Following the fumble recovery, Watson. And they are just not going to let up as he is into the end zone here for 2 more.
I guess when you're hot, I mean, I would just go ahead and take the extra point and move on, but apparently they've got something to prove. Almost feels like something was said this week, and they wanted to make sure that they laid it on them in this game.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30.
At their own 33-yard line.
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway.
Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case. There's too much to handle on the other side in this one.
2nd and 10 from the 33-yard line. Throwing again, Wilson. That's caught by his tight end, Foster Moreau. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be 3rd and less than a yard.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes,
It used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
Wilson now to throw on third down. He's got Lockett. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. A Seahawk first down as Wilson finds Lockett.
First and 10 at the 44-yard line.
Again, Wilson. Trying to lay one up deep. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. A big pickup of 38. Defensively, I know they have the comfortable lead here in the 4th, but they do not want to give up big plays like that.
They want to finish strong. So oftentimes in this situation, you tighten up underneath in your coverage, and you bring your safeties back. They can pick up anything that leaks through. But in the meantime, upfield, you're making plays on the football.
So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They've got it first and goal as they look to punch in a late score. Throwing again here, Wilson. His pass caught at the 4. Richard lost it, and now the Rams have got it, going the other way.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And it would appear that the open week a week ago came just at the right time as they have dominated the proceedings here into this fourth quarter. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in. Historically, this is such a tough, loud venue, but you can hear a pin drop right now. A lot of fans long gone, not used to seeing a lopsided score like this.
He's going to take another shot here. And got his man complete.
And they finally get him down, but not before he reaches the 34. And Watson's going to throw it here, escaping the pressure right. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. It's another first down as they look his way again, this time 19 yards. And the Rams are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. And give him another 6. It's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues.
Well, business as usual for them, well on their way to another victory, riding a serious wave of momentum from what we've seen. And so far, they haven't met their match. So if you're going to play this team in the future, your mission is clear. You better be ready to play and match their firepower.
Forced out to his left. And this is going to be caught. So add 2 more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the 4th. So they go with a pass there on the 2-point try and able to convert it, Charles.
And a good job by the offense figuring out their 2-point play and using it well. It's interesting how people are using the strategy nowadays, though, isn't it?
It really is, and I don't know how. Now a hit and a loose football. And now the Rams have got it, going the other way.
You thought you had it, didn't you? You thought you had it.
And that might just submit it. A return for a late touchdown. And for them, this train, it just keeps rolling, doesn't it? Well on their way to yet another victory.
Yeah, it's almost a runaway, isn't it? And you just wonder how anyone could stop this. They got full momentum going, full confidence going. But it's not just their own confidence that is leading them. It's the lack of confidence against their opponents now, because they see them coming and think, we've got no shot to beat this team.
So a big play there, not only the fumble return for the touchdown, then they get the 2-point try. And you know, for the defense, though, they were just over there sitting on the field. They had to rush out to try to defend that.
You know, it's funny. They actually practice situations that they call sudden change when the team turns it over. I guarantee you no one practices a fumble return for a touchdown like that, and now someone goes for 2. Really good strategy by them putting them in that situation.
And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the 4th quarter. This would be their 3rd straight defeat. And that'll be incomplete with 11 seconds remaining now.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense.
The hit comes late. We saw it. There's your flag.
And we know that there's a guideline, right? Ball's gone. You get one step. If you're within one step of the quarterback, you can hit him as long as it's still done legally. But anything outside of that, looks like an extra step was involved.
And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. They'll contain him to just four. Second down. Throwing again on second down. Wilson. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory, and the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week, we'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points, allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Rams, that early momentum continues here as they move to 4-0. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Arizona.
Let me explain what I did. Can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a range. Can I kick it? Yeah. Don't ask me a thing. How I got or how I did it. Yeah. Spend the whole half. Had a blast. Can I kick it? Even with a sprain. Pain. Can I kick it? Just the flex. I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same. Things have changed. Can I kick it? People acting different. So I ask. Can I?
Hey. Could count on my power and look at my dial. So way back then, claim what you saw, but you weren't with us. The higher the climb, the harder the fall, but how did you get up? I done got rich, then went broke, then got rich again, just a little hiccup. I done been ballin' this pickup. Remember me being so bummy and being so hungry, I had to eat gristle. How did the lady go miss? How she was magic, she mixed. Met her at one of the funks, and we caught her the rhythm. She caught up a friend, they kissed, and we dipped it, and that's how we kicked it.
Let me explain what I did. Can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a range. Can I kick it? Yeah. Don't ask me a thing. How I got or how I did it. Yeah. Spend the whole half. Had a blast. Can I kick it? Even with a sprain. Pain. Can I kick it? Get the flex. I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same. Things